it can be tough to stay in shape, especially as you get older. Casey and the sports doctor traveled to the Battle of Stonington 5K so that the sports doctor could learn firsthand that fitness can start, improve, and even flourish after the age of 40.
The Battle of Stonington is a commemorative of the battle that was fought here in 1812. Started this race about 20 years ago. We draw about 250 people from all over New England. Our largest segment of runners is actually over 40 years old, and we actually have a few competitors over 70.
The battle was shaping up. The Battle of Keiths. Run 169 Society's Keith Coburn and our own Keith O'Brien were similar in age, but one certainly had the edge in experience and training.
Sports doctor, how old are you?
48 years old, Casey.
And Keith?
49.
All right, so he's got a year on you. You've been training for this race for a little while. How long have you been training?
About 2 weeks. I've been out running in the morning and stuff before work.
And Keith, how long have you been a runner?
I've been a runner for about 3 years.
So 3 years compared to 3 weeks. And we're going to see after the race how that translates into your times.
215 people ran the Battle of Stonington, each with a unique backstory of how they started, why they continue, who and what motivates them to run. These stories are the heart of any race.
There was a point where I got unfit, unhealthy, and I needed to make a change, and it started really on a treadmill.
You know, I wasn't in the greatest shape, and I just decided to make a significant life change to really ramp it up. I have two young daughters, and you know, I wanted to be a good role model for them as well.
Started running about 15 years ago, and then I got the bug after that. Not in my wildest dreams did I think I would run Boston, not once, but three times.
10 years ago, racing a race in Hawaii, and during the bike, I had my stroke, which caused a lot of problems. So I went from being the top of the game to all of a sudden starting way at the beginning. We're learning how to walk again.
Had to deal with some injury issues because I'm not 20 anymore. Part of what I do now on a daily basis is I put yoga type stretching in my routine, and I do a lot of core exercise.
My training regimen is more like 3 days a week. I try to give my body a little bit of a break on the off days.
You just got to be active, and as you age, you have to temper yourself, and you just have to be careful of what you're doing and listen to your body.
You have to have specific goals. You got to set those goals, and you got to follow them.
Never give up, and always think about there's everybody around you that's thinking about you, so just don't give up and enjoy life.
The finish line of any race is the emotional epicenter, the place where accomplishment and joy defeat exhaustion and self-doubt. At the end of every race, everyone is a winner.
All right, so here we are at the end of the Battle of Stonington. The Battle of the Keiths went as expected. For our official times, Keith, what did you have yourself finishing at?
22:04 or 5, something like that.
Which is right in line with, which was right in line with a really outstanding performance. And where did the sports doctor come in?
I broke 32 minutes, so he was actually 10 minutes faster than me. But you know what? I finished a race.
Keith Coburn may have won the Battle of the Keiths.
Good job.
But our own sports doctor earned respect and accolades because he faced the challenge, finished the race, and showed that fitness can continue after 40.